In northern Thailand, Chiang Mai was once the capital of a kingdom with a rich history and many beautiful temples. We see highlights of six key temples, and I'll provide some history along the way. A number of years ago, my wife and I traveled to Thailand and spent time in the northern city of Chiang Mai. It has 117 Buddhist temples, and its cultural heart is its walled old city. The first temple we see is Wat Chiang Man, the oldest, with an elephant chedi. Next is Wat Chedi Leung, with the largest chedi in Chiang Mai. Wat Prasing has impressive wax figures and Chiang Mai's most revered Buddha statue. Just outside the old city is Wat Chet Yat, with fabulous architecture and an old budai tree. Wat Suan Dok has a royal cemetery and is said to house a relic of the Buddha. And lastly is the fabulous and most famous Wat Prathat Doi Suthep, high on the mountain overlooking the city below. The Lanna Kingdom was founded in 1296 with Chiang Mai as its capital. The temples we visit were founded by kings from this kingdom. In the 1700s, the Burmese from present-day Myanmar took control over the Lanna Kingdom and the Kingdom of Siam to the south. In 1775, Chiang Mai revolted, and with the help from Siam, they regained independence from Burma. The Lanna region then became part of the Kingdom of Siam, today's Thailand. We stay at a wonderful hotel on the western perimeter of the old city. There is a large variety of accommodations in Chiang Mai. If you're here on a Sunday, you can visit the Sunday Walking Street Market in the Old City. It gets very busy with numerous shopping opportunities and has restaurants and temples nearby. You can also choose an accommodation near here if you wish. East of the old city in a commercial area, we visit a night bazaar which sets up every evening. There are many restaurants and pubs nearby here as well.
Also get some very good Thai food.
And check out this beer.
Here are the beautiful grounds of Wat Chiang Man. It was the first royal temple built by the first king of Lanna after the founding of Chiang Mai in 1296. So it's the oldest temple in the city. Like most wats, the oldest structure is the chedi, and this one is named the Elephant Chedi, as it sits on a square base surrounded by 16 elephants. A chedi is usually a bell-shaped tower which often contains the relic of a Buddha or sometimes the ashes of a king or an important monk. Wat Chedi Luang means the Temple of the Great Chedi, and this one is the largest in Chiang Mai. In the 14th century, the king built this chedi for his father. It originally was 82 meters high and the tallest structure in the Lanna Kingdom. An earthquake in 1545 collapsed the top third. Back then, it housed the Emerald Buddha, originally from Sri Lanka and considered the most sacred Buddha image in the kingdom. After the earthquake, the Emerald Buddha was moved to another location in Lanna, and can now be found in Wat Prakeo in Bangkok. The chedi was partially restored in the early 1990s. And this large standing Buddha dates back to when Wat Chedi Luang was founded at the end of the 14th century. Wat Prasing is also known as the Monastery of the Lion Buddha. It's one of the most important temples in Chiang Mai, and the finest example of classic Lhana architecture. It was built by King Fiyu in 1345 when Chiang Mai was capital of the Lhana Kingdom. This large gold Buddha was cast in 1477. That realistic-looking monk is actually wax. At the time, I wasn't sure, so I stayed back. Here is where I realized the four-seated monks were actually wax. Each wat covers a large area and includes a number of buildings in each complex. I later learned that this wat is famous for the Prasing Buddha statue, which the temple gets its name, and it was housed in a building in the back corner of the grounds, and I didn't notice at the time. Every April during the Soen Kran festival, which celebrates the traditional Asian New Year, the Prasing Buddha is paraded through the streets of Chiang Mai. This interesting building is a library. Wat Chet Yat is an attractive temple complex northwest of Chiang Mai's old city. Its architecture reflects various styles, including Lhana, Siam, Lao, Chinese, and Indian influences. It was built by the King of the Lhana Kingdom, who reigned from 1441 to 1487. The king's ashes are enshrined in the chedi. The Bodai tree was planted in 1455, probably to commemorate 2,000 years of Buddhism. The next year, the 8th Buddhist World Council was held here. Just west of Chiang Mai's old city is Wat Suan Dock, founded in 1370 by the King of Lhana. Its name means Flower Garden Temple. All these smaller white chedis contain ashes of several generations of the Chiang Mai royal family. The tall gold chedi is in Sri Lankan style and contains a relic of the Buddha. As the story goes, a monk had discovered what was believed to be the shoulder bone of the Buddha, so the king invited the monk to Chiang Mai and had this chedi built to enshrine the Buddha relic. When the monk arrived, the bone magically split into two pieces, one of the original size and a smaller one. So the smaller relic was enshrined here, and the king ordered the larger piece to be put on a white elephant and was then set free to roam at will. The elephant climbed up the mountain just west of Chiang Mai, where it died. So another temple was built at that location, which we visit next. We now head up the mountain, where we have a fabulous view of Chiang Mai below. Remember the story of the king who had the relic of the Buddha put on a white elephant? Well, here is Chiang Mai's most sacred and lavishly decorated temple. Wat Phrathat Doi Suthep was founded in 1383, where the white elephant trumpeted three times and died. The large Buddha relic he carried on his back is enshrined here. Subsequent kings added to this temple. This Wat is very impressive. If you enjoy my videos, I encourage you to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified of new releases. It's free, and sharing with your friends is much appreciated.